Fortgang, Berman Fortgang is the real deal, but Fortgang for assembly just sounds better. So I'm Laura Fortgang. I'm a mom of three. I'm a wife. I'm a business owner. I'm an interfaith minister. I am an author five times over. I've been on the Oprah Winfrey Show. And I have a TED Talk with almost 1 million views. Wow. But here's the best part. I'm running for state assembly in the 27th district. And I'm running because I can no longer stand on the sidelines and watch New Jersey go further into the hole that it has created for itself. I cannot stand by and let that happen. I am seeing New Jersey in a crisis of affordability. We have some of the biggest pharmaceutical companies right here in New Jersey on the verge of curing cancer, and we have people who can't afford medication. We have a ranking in this country of our public schools as number two, but we're shutting kids out of opportunities, and they're applying and getting turned away from two-thirds of them from Morris County VOTEC because they want more advanced training. We have some of the best jobs. They require commuting, and we have a transportation system that's archaic and broken. New Jersey is putting its resources in the wrong places, and it's time to bring them to the right places so that people can stay in New Jersey. Are students having student debt coming home because they couldn't afford to go to college even in New Jersey? Thank you. So they have student debt and can't afford to launch here in New Jersey, living on mom and dad's couch, or they leave. We've got our senior citizens not able to stay in their homes that they paid off because they can't afford the taxes. So they're moving to other states. This should not be happening in New Jersey. Not in New Jersey. I'm sorry. Now, I think I might be able to help because I have worked for 25 years with individuals, small business owners, and corporations and organizations like NASA, the Army Corps of Engineers, the World Bank, and McDonald's, just to be fair. And they call me because they cannot solve problems that they cannot see their way through anymore. So they call me to help them solve the problems they can't see anymore because they're too close to it. And those skills required are to listen, to help people see the solution that's probably right in front of them that they can't see anymore, to get people to work together and to move everybody forward. New Jersey needs to move forward, but in a real way, not just keeping things going the way they've been. I want to bring those skills to Trenton because we have gridlock in Trenton. I want to stand up to politics that happen in back rooms with handshakes. I want New Jersey, thank you, please. I want to stand up against transactional politics and make the people of New Jersey the priority again. What a concept. What happens if we're the priority? We need to make our healthcare costs lower so that we can, therefore, be able to take big worries off our plate. Now, if we keep it in New Jersey and we have a big pool, we can do that in New Jersey. Why aren't we doing that in New Jersey? Yes, there's one clap. I'll take one. I live the healthcare nightmare in my own home. So my child has epilepsy since he's 4 years old. He's now 18. Two of his five medications are uncovered by insurance at the tune of $1,600 a month. I just got a letter last week that our insurance will be going up by $20,000 a year if we'd like to keep the same level of coverage. That should not be happening. That we need to do something about that. Now, our healthcare costs are not just for my kitchen table and your kitchen table, they affect our schools. The top line, heaviest item in the budget is healthcare costs for our school budgets. And that affects all of us because less money's being put on curriculum. And when we stabilize healthcare costs and we help our school budgets, it'll be hopefully less of a burden on the municipality. Because most of our municipalities, they pay for the burden of our public schools. The state funding is just barely being looked at again and coming back to our towns. So my priorities are that, healthcare, education, and our taxes. In New Jersey, with our education, as I told you before, in Morris County, two-thirds of the kids who want to go to VOTEC in Morris County get turned away. Two-thirds. Now, this isn't the VOTEC of our past. Now in VoTech, we're teaching IT, we're teaching engineering, we're teaching organic farming, we're training kids for green jobs. They can go out with a, get a job immediately after high school with a certificate. They can go to a two-year program, they can go to a four-year program. This needs to be in more of our schools. The old plan of like get good grades and go to college, it leaves you on your parents' couch because those jobs are not those jobs anymore. And so if we improve our VoTech and we have kids being ready for the most technical jobs, the most advanced jobs, that's security for New Jersey. It will keep our kids here, but also attract businesses here. So that we, anywhere where there's a workplace ready to fill jobs, we will attract businesses. And this then will help broaden the tax pool and lessen again the burden on each of us. So I do have a vision for New Jersey of what's possible. And it starts with healthcare to education, to our taxes, to us developing a workforce that can grow here and stay here. That's what I want to fight for. My name is Fortgang. It actually means forward motion. It actually means forward motion. So I want to find solutions that bring everybody forward to make New Jersey affordable for all of us again. And speaking of affordability, as Mayor Soriano pointed out, this is an expensive race. Betty Lou DeCroce and Jay Weber both raise each $250,000 every time they run for their re-election. I'm being told I need to raise $500,000 because it costs $3 to $5 to reach every single voter so that we can get my name out there and people know that this year, which is usually a low turnout year because at the top of the ticket is assembly, that this race is just as sexy as the last one. Just as sexy as 2018. And it has nothing to do with wearing a skirt or being able to hold a ball.
Which you do both very well.
I'm still holding on to it. So with that said, we do need your help in every way that you can give it. We need canvassers, phone bankers. You are so gracious to be here tonight, and thank you again to our host. And your money makes a difference too. Please remember that. Please sign up with us so that we can keep track of you and you of me. And let's find solutions and move New Jersey forward. Thank you.